welcome. Happy Easter, if that's something that you celebrate. Otherwise, happy Sunday. iRest, what a practice. And you guys, there's so many new people to it today. So congratulations for starting this practice. It is a practice I can say from personal experience that is really transforming. And you may notice results or benefits right away. Or it might be something that takes more time, like any other practice. You might have spurts where sometimes you feel a lot of inspiration, a lot of growth after a session, and then other times you maybe even feel more challenged, like there was more friction. Totally normal. What the practice is it's a guided meditation. So you're going to be still for most of the practice. You're going to be as comfortable as possible, lying down with support under the knees, under the chest, hopefully some sort of weight or pillow across the lap or the legs, the low belly, a blanket, even a weighted eye pillow, talking as comfortable as possible. So until then, while I talk about the practice, I want to give you guys some time to move around a little bit. You're not trying to create heat or exercise, but just a little bit of stretching. So that can be rolling through the wrists, can be rolling through the shoulders, opening the chest, maybe doing some seated or traditional cat-cows, that spinal flexion and extension. You can stretch through the backs of the legs. You know, if you want to, you can stand up and do dangle pose. You can sit with the legs stretched out long in front of you and fold forward. And that'll accomplish stretching the low back, the glutes, and the backs of the legs. Either way, just take this time to not really worry about looking at me or what I'm doing and just worry about getting into your body. Really let the focus be moving. If you're already comfortable and you're already laying down and in your position, still take this time for movement because the body's going to want some sort of movement before about 35 to 45 minutes of listening, of just being still. So you can roll through the wrists, through the ankles. Think about creative ways to move. Even if you're laying down, maybe it's moving one finger at a time. Maybe it's swirling the fingers around. Maybe it's twisting the belly just a little bit or moving through the neck. So you take that time individually and take care of your body, trying to get every bit of the body involved in some way. So even if that just means squeezing through the tush, you know, getting your glutes just to work just enough to remember they're there, or flexing through the quads to lift the kneecaps just a bit, that's all going to help your practice of stillness later. So speaking of stillness, in iRest, in this type of meditation, we want the body to be as relaxed as possible so that the body almost thinks it's asleep. And what that does is it lets the mind do some real work. Our oxygen gets to go more towards our brain, and so the brain is able to do more activity. And what we work on is neuroplasticity. We're making new neural pathways in the brain. What happens often is we get in these patterns of thinking, and it's not our fault. It's a stressful time right now. If you are in a time of worry, in a time of concern, most of us are, just with the current events of COVID. I'll say the bad word. But you know, there's other things going on too in everyone's lives. There's financial stress. I won't say it. You know what it is for you. Everyone knows what their big thing is, what's filling up their worry box. So during that time, it's natural and normal for the brain to focus on that because it's what our heart is attached to. The problem is that a well-worn path is well-worn because it's well-used. So as we continue to have those thoughts and keep thinking about those thoughts, it's easier for that to become our default. So as we begin to default towards stress and worry and anxiety and fear, that becomes the new normal pathway for our brain. And it's really hard to break a habit when you're not aware of how it's being made or that it's even there. All you feel are the effects. You feel you know, the heaviness in the chest, you feel the restless nights, you feel the stomach aches, even the anger. Sometimes it comes out as anger. For people with PTSD, rage is something that is very closely linked, and that's because it's an outlet. So if you've witnessed things that have been really awful, sometimes the best way to protect yourself is to be angry. And that's because the brain has made these pathways. So what iRest does is it works on making new pathways. And it's not in a way that you're totally aware of. So I'm not going to say it's hypnosis, because it's definitely not hypnosis. But it's definitely not all conscious either. So what it does is we work through different layers, and what we call in this practice, we call those layers koshas. So we start with, you know, knowing the breath, the what the five senses are, what's going around us, and then we just go deeper and deeper and deeper into the self. So we're going to start today. I'm going to first, because we have so many new people, we're going to work on our inner resource a bit. Our sankalpa, our desire, our intention, our why for starting the practice. And we focused on that a bit last time as well, but you can never focus too much on that. And then we're going to work through those layers. And again, what those layers are is it's kind of starting outward, big picture, and then getting closer and closer and closer until we find the deepest part of ourselves, our essence. And according to yoga, according to this practice, Dr. Richard Miller took a very ancient practice of yoga nidra, and he made it clinically safe. He took out the triggers, and he added a lot of psychological stuff that makes it beneficial as far as the brain and the patterns of the brain goes. And he made it so that we can get to the deepest essence. And what that essence is joy. It's well-being. The essence of all of us, how we are all meant to feel, is happy and joyful. And all of the stuff along the way, all of the things that we're dealing with right now, the stress, all of those worn paths in our minds, those are obstacles. You know, sometimes it's like you think of a river that has just worn water so deep that now there's this huge canyon. You can think of the Grand Canyon. So the Grand Canyon may not be an obstacle to jump over. Well, I mean, I guess it could. It's not like a hurdle per se, but you know, maybe it's something you have to go down in the trenches. You know, it could be something you have to go down and work through. And there's tools that we use in the practice to do that. And the biggest tool that we use to work through the stuff is called our inner resource. And so what the inner resource is, oftentimes it's a place. It's what people call their happy place. And yeah, for a lot of people, you know, they can think of a scene or a type of place. For me, I love the mountains. I love the beach, but I really love the mountains and I love trees. You'll notice that's my background behind me. So for me, that's an easy place for me to begin with my inner resource. But you'll notice that it's not always a place. Sometimes it's a moment in time. And then you can start adding in more detail. So when we're building our inner resource, you can start with an image, but then go deeper. You add in the five senses. You add in memory. You add in emotion. And you add in time. You let it become this moment that you're getting to live concurrently at the same time as the moment that you're actually living, but it's totally separate. And instead of thinking of it as avoiding the current moment, they're happening together side by side. So it's kind of like, think about a motorcycle with a sidecar. You now have a sidecar full of safety. So what you're doing is you're now going through these hard, difficult paths, but you have this sidecar with you that's keeping you emotionally anchored down. So anytime that you begin to feel triggered, you start to feel stressed, panicky, anxious, you can go to that. And that can be during this practice, absolutely during this practice. If at any time you start to feel anxious, you're going to go up to that inner resource that we're going to work on together to build, but also in your daily life. It's, in fact, recommended that you practice your inner resource multiple times a day. And it doesn't have to be for long. While you're cooking dinner, while you're brushing your teeth, you can just think about it. Help build it up, because it's going to change. It's a living, breathing thing, this item. And you remember it, eventually easier and easier, to where you just think inner resource. It's almost like a buzzword for yourself. And then you think of that thing, and the wave of peace and safety and well-being that it gives you just washes over you. And then eventually, over time, your inner resource begins to remember you. So when your body begins to feel anxious or stressed or any of those things, your inner resource will come to you before you even call for it. So it's a pretty cool thing. But it takes time. We've got to build those pathways. It takes practice. So that's why with this practice today, I'm going to be sending each of you through the email, through MindBody, a link to this video. That way you can redo your practice and practice it over and over. Each time you do iRest with me, I will send you a copy. That way you can sustain the practice, because the more you use your brain, the bigger it grows. It's a muscle. You know, prefrontal cortex versus your amygdala. That's where our fears versus our reasoning, you know, they shift. So one will get bigger and stronger as the other is weaker, and they'll shift their power. So that's what this practice does. So I hope that that gave you all plenty of time to get all the wiggles out, all the stretches out. And let's go ahead and start getting comfortable if you haven't already. I'm going to drink the water that my toddler drank out of, so please wish me luck. Okay, so again, getting very, very comfortable. I would suggest having your arms slightly away from your body, palms up, chin slightly below the level of the forehead. And if you're comfortable now letting the eyes close, let them close now. If you're not comfortable with letting the eyes close for any reason, know that that's okay. You can have your eyes open the entire practice, okay? Let your legs be slightly apart. Perhaps the heels are inward of the toes, so the toes are falling out a bit. Support beneath the knees, maybe with a blanket or soft pillow. Try to keep the low back very comfortable. That natural lumbar curve should be supported as well. Either space you could slide your hand under or a pillow. And then notice where you are as far as comfort. If you could be 5 or 10% more comfortable, what would that look like? Maybe even making just a little more room to breathe. Can you spread your collarbones wider by pulling the outer edges of the shoulders apart, letting the ribcage flare open in front? Take some cleansing breaths. And begin to notice, begin to welcome, to truly welcome any sensation that you feel of comfort or discomfort. So if you're someone who suffers from chronic physical pain, I'd like you to acknowledge it right now. Instead of trying to avoid it, notice that it's there. You don't have to welcome it as a friend, but you can acknowledge its presence just fine. And as well as physical sensations, I'd like you to allow yourself to welcome any thoughts that come up, any memories or emotions, anything that's cognitive. Try to think of everything that comes up in your mind, every stray thought, every feeling, as a messenger. Another way to think of it is as a teacher. So if you're having a response to something, if you're having a thought, there's an opportunity to learn from it, no matter what it is. Sometimes asking yourself a very open-ended question like why can really help you learn a lot about that reaction that you're having. And if your reaction that you're having is negative and it begins to give you those feelings of anxiety or panic or stress, again, we're going to come to that inner resource. So now that the body's comfortable, allow the breath to be comfortable as well. Breathing in and out. Breathe in and out through the nose or the mouth or a combination. There's no rules. In fact, the only two rules of iRest is that you can't do it wrong. So whatever your practice is like today is perfect. If you fall asleep and you snore, that's perfect. It's what your body needed. Your mind is still hearing me, so there's still some cleanup work being done. If you're antsy the whole time and you feel irritation, you feel bored or wiggly, that's a perfect practice too, because something's being stirred up inside of you. So just know, you can't do it wrong. You're already here, your practice has started, you're in it, baby. The other rule is that everything is a messenger, everything's a teacher, okay? So with that, with the breath now feeling easier, softer, hopefully the body feeling at ease and comfortable, begin to soften the face. Notice how supported your body is, how comfortable you are. And then notice the internal climate that you feel. What kind of moods did you bring to your practice today? What kind of feelings? It's okay to acknowledge if they're negative or positive, if there's specific stressors or not. Sometimes we don't bring much to our practice. We just kind of show up because we did. That's fine too. Just be with whatever's present. And now we're going to start to build up that inner resource together. So what I'd like you to do is, with the eyes closed, I'd like you to either think of your happiest memory or think of a place that when you think of it feels like it could become your happiest memory if it were real. So for some people, this is somewhere outside. Nature, maybe somewhere tropical or in the mountains or at a lake. Perhaps it's somewhere back in time, in your great-grandpa's yard, a tire swing. Anything that when you think of it, you get that surge of joy, of happiness. It's authentic, it's not forced. Sometimes there's even a tinge of sadness because it's not real, and that's okay, we can work with that. But what we want is that happiness that comes first. If it's hard for you to imagine visually, some people have a hard time imagining things in their mind. It can also be a quote, can be a phrase, can be a smell. Welcoming any memories that are rising up. And then begin to use the five senses to build it. And again, we're just beginning to create this inner resource now. We'll go deeper into it in our practice. So, what do you smell? What do you see? Do you hear, feel? Are there tastes? Now begin to come back to the present, leaving that inner resource. Now that we have an idea of what it might be like there, come back to where you are. If you need to open the eyes and look around, you can, but you'll probably do this with your eyes closed. And just like we did a moment ago, I'd like you to use your five senses. So starting with what you feel. Can you feel air on your skin anywhere? What about the weight of blankets or props on top of you? Texture beneath you, support. Even fabric, clothing. Feeling the body without seeing it. Notice if there's any smells present. Perhaps you just had dinner and you can still smell some of the lingering aromas. If you have an eye pillow, maybe it's herbal. Maybe there's lavender for you to smell. Or maybe you just like to imagine a smell now. That's fine too. Olfactory memory is real, so whatever smell you'd like to think of. What about taste? Move your tongue around your mouth. You can allow yourself to salivate just a little extra. Not doing this in a strange way, but just noticing, is there a sweet taste? Maybe more astringent? Stale? It's okay to notice those tastes too. Are there colors or shapes behind your eyelids? Perhaps even in your third eye, you see a color. What is it? Now, what do you hear? This is a big one. We're going to start with the obvious, like my voice. And now, what's the obvious sounds that you hear in the room that you're in? It can be all sorts of things. And you can welcome in distraction. It's okay. Because they're all just going to blur into the background. And it helps us really find our present moment. So if there's pets walking around, kids playing upstairs, partners tinkering around the garage, just acknowledge it with a smile. Welcome it as part of your practice. And then move on to the next least obvious thing. Noticing everything you can possibly hear. Notice through the sense of hearing. Perhaps you can hear your breath. Maybe sounds outside of the house, cars, neighbors. Allowing this to relax you instead of cause you angst. Soften the space between the eyebrows, soften the temples. And now begin to think about the sounds that you can anticipate hearing, that you don't hear right now, but you hear them fairly often, so you can expect them to happen. So maybe doors opening and closing, people walking around, again, pets walking around, cars. Any normal house sounds. In fact, from me, besides the sound of my voice, you're going to hear papers flipping as I move through my notes. I have lots of notes and cards that I write for these practices, so I'm going to be flipping through all of those. So be prepared for that as well. Let it be part of your practice today. Welcome every experience as a messenger, as a teacher, as something maybe even deep inside yourself trying to tell you something. But really pay attention to the things that feel like sensations, emotions, thoughts, and hopefully the recognition of being spacious awareness. Spacious awareness is the fact that you are not any of those things. You are the space in which all of the life circumstances come and go. You are not the bad things that are happening to you. You are the soul energy. You're not financial troubles. You're not sickness. You aren't danger. You're you. And you're coping with those things. So finding the ability to be spacious awareness is finding the ability to recognize that you're like the blue sky. My favorite thing to relate to. You're the blue sky. Everything else is the weather. Sometimes it's hard to see the blue sky. Sometimes it's impossible through the clouds and the storms. But it's still there. You're still there, even if you don't feel like you. Sometimes the blue sky is really bright. You know, sometimes there's a single white fluffy cloud. So the time that you can recognize that you are just what everything else is coming and going through is a time that you can search for your essence, for your joy, for that color of blue that's you. It's like in meditation, the space between the thoughts. And you can really savor that and observe. It's where you can learn a lot about yourself and how you react to things. In fact, it's where you can respond instead of react. So I'd like you to welcome each messenger. Imagine that they're coming to you, almost coming to your guest house. They're just stopping by, giving you a little bit of awareness. And I'd like you to greet them with curiosity, with openness, with interest. Let it perk your ears up a bit, just enough to notice, and then let it go. So with our senses still wide open, I want you to allow each perception to come to you. So again, the sounds around your body. Senses are still open, so we're still feeling the touch of air on the skin. Surfaces providing support. What about sensations within the body? Can you feel the aliveness, the vital life force inside of you? In yoga, we call it prana, the breath, the blood moving. Can you just feel aliveness? If not, that's okay. Just notice what you notice. We're going to move on to the sankalpa, which is our intention, our heartfelt desire for the practice. So intention is more short term. It's what's going to help us towards our heartfelt desire. So your intention for today's practice, go ahead and think about it. Could have been, if you're a practitioner, maybe today you wanted to stay alert and awake the whole time. Maybe you wanted to work through a particular sensation or an emotion or a belief that you've been dealing with, kind of working through. Maybe you wanted to find joy and awareness, peace, relaxation. Whatever your reason was for getting on your mat, for getting into your practice today, I'd like you to fully welcome it. You can even thank it. It got you here. And begin affirming your intention with your entire body and your mind. Can you feel a shift in your body? You notice that shift. Now we're going to go through our heartfelt desire. Now that's our heart's deepest desire, our wish or our mission. Think of it long term, okay? It's not just today. It's not how you want to feel as a result of your practice just today. It's what you want all of your practices of all of your days to lead to. So your intention is kind of like your ally. It's working with you to help make that heartfelt desire happen. Okay? I want you to think about that feeling of your life, living through your deepest longing. Okay, what would that be? It could be health, healing, perhaps an awakening of some sort. It could be a spontaneous desire that you wish to manifest more than anything in your lifetime. Something that gives you a sense of purpose and meaning. Affirming and experiencing this felt sense of your heartfelt desire is true in this moment. So now letting there be a shift from what you really want most in life to allowing it in this moment to be what's true. This is those new pathways in the brain we talked about. Giving yourself some time here. As you're ready, set your heartfelt desire aside, as if you're neatly just placing it very gently next to you, because you're going to pick it back up later, welcoming it, how it may affirm itself throughout your practice and in your daily life. And now let's go back towards our inner resource, the third part of our sankalpa. So bring attention to that inner resource. Resting back into and experiencing the felt sense of peace there, of happiness, the positive well-being, maybe that sense of being unchanging. Because when we're in our happy place, nothing can touch us, nothing can affect us negatively. So think of it as being an unchanging being in that place. Safe haven, refuge, somewhere that you can feel very secure, very at ease. There's no danger there. Only help, only comfort, all of your favorite things. You can even let people or pets come in too. And begin welcoming the felt sense of being and well-being. Spacious, open, timeless, perfect, familiar, unchanging, yet fresh and always present. If helpful, again, invite in people, images, perhaps a wise man or woman that has helped you. It can be an object or a place in nature. Images that nourish feelings of being secure, peaceful, and at ease. And that felt sense of being and well-being throughout your body. Know that you can return to your inner resource at any time during your practice. Day or night, daily life. It's not just for this hour, it's for your whole life. You're creating a safe space inside of your mind to help get you through all of the troubles of life. Okay? It's a tool. So you can return here day or night throughout your practice whenever you need to feel totally secure and at ease. Now, allow my words to be your words. Allow my voice to become your voice as we rotate attention throughout the body. Sensing your jaw, lips, teeth, gums, mouth, the ceiling of the mouth, the floor of the mouth, the inner walls, the left side and the right side of the inner cheeks. Now the tongue, back of the throat, the entire jaw and mouth as sensation. allowing thoughts like helium balloons to float up and away without becoming involved with them. Instead, welcoming sensations just as they are. Sensation of the left ear, right ear, both ears at the same time as one sensation. Left nostril. Right nostril. The flow of air and sensation inside both nostrils. Left eye. Eyebrow. Temple. Cheekbone. The entire left eye as sensation. Right eye. Eyebrow. Temple. Cheekbone. The right eye as sensation. Both eyes at the same time. Both eyes as one field of radiant sensation. Without analyzing, instead sensing your way. Forehead. Crown, top of the head, back of the head and neck, sensation within the neck, left shoulder, left upper arm, elbow, forearm, wrist, the left hand and the fingers, the entire left arm from palm to shoulder as radiant or vibrating sensation. Right shoulder, right upper arm, elbow, forearm, wrist, right hand and fingers. The entire right arm, palm to shoulder, as radiant, vibrating sensation. Upper chest and back. Mid chest. And back, belly, and lower back, ceiling of the torso, floor of the torso, the entire torso, a sphere of radiant sensation. Letting go of thinking, the entire torso alive as sensation, radiating inwardly and outwardly in all directions. left leg, left hip, left thigh, knee, foreleg, and calf, ankle, left foot and toes. The entire left foot and leg as vibrant sensation, alert, attentive. Sensing now the right leg, right hip, right thigh, knee, foreleg, and calf, ankle, foot, and toes. The entire right foot and leg as vibrant sensation. Sensing both legs at the same time as vibrating sensation. Sensing the front of the body. Back of the body. Left side. Right side. Inside the body. Surface sensations. Welcoming the entire body as vibrant sensation, radiating in all directions, inwardly and outwardly. Welcoming every experience that is now present, while interweaving your inner resource of being and well-being throughout your body. Feeling secure and at ease. Note how all of these sensations, as well as passing thoughts, emotions, and images, how they're all constantly changing, coming and going. The entire body constantly changing as a field of sensation. And become aware of all that you are now aware of. How sensation is a movement within awareness. And feel back into that awareness itself. Try to sense yourself as spacious, unchanging awareness in which all of the changing sensations are arising and unfolding. Changing sensation revealing unchanging awareness. Sense the body breathing itself, letting go of analyzing and thinking, just the natural flow of sensation as breath enters and leaves the body. Nostrils, walls of the throat, the gentle rise and release of the chest and abdomen. Welcoming sensation and the body breathing itself. The body is breathing itself. While sensing the abdomen rising and releasing as breath naturally flows in and flows out, begin counting from 1 to 7 like this. 1, Inhaling, abdomen rising and expanding. One, exhaling, abdomen releasing and relaxing. Two, inhaling, abdomen rising and expanding. Two, exhaling, abdomen releasing and relaxing. Continue counting with your body's own natural breathing and rhythm. If you lose count, restart at one. Alert, attentive, completely absorbed in counting from 1 to 7 as the body breathes itself. Counting, body breathing itself. Abdomen expanding, relaxing. Alert, attentive. Counting as the body breathes itself. When it feels right, allow counting to fall away while remaining attentive to flows of sensation and energy throughout the body. Alert, attentive, the body a field of radiant sensation. Welcoming every experience that is now present while interweaving your inner resource of being and well-being throughout your body. Feeling it as a physical sensation, feeling secure and at ease. Letting counting fall away completely, staying with the flows of energy and sensation that are present. Body still breathing itself, not analyzing, simply welcoming sensation. Note how all of these sensations, as well as passing thoughts, emotions, and images are constantly changing, coming and going, the entire body a constantly changing field of radiant sensation. Sense all that you are now aware of, how sensation is a movement within awareness. Feel back into awareness itself. Sensing yourself as spacious, unchanging awareness in which all of the changing sensations are arising and unfolding. Changing sensation revealing unchanging awareness. The entire body as a radiant field of sensation, radiating in all directions simultaneously, inwardly and outwardly. Bring attention to sensations of well-being, happiness, joy, bliss, anything positive that's present. Welcome and feel an inner smile radiating from your heart, radiating joy everywhere from the heart. Expanding and spreading throughout your entire torso, to your hands and arms, pelvis, legs and feet. Every cell throughout the entire body radiantly alive with feelings of well-being, happiness, joy or bliss. If it's helpful, remember someone who you love or someone someone who loves you. Allowing this image of a special person or particular circumstance from your life to activate feelings of well-being and joy throughout your body. Then allow the image or the specific memory to fall away, but hold on to the feelings of the body. Simply experience the feeling of well-being, happiness, and joy. Feeling yourself being absorbed in and as joy. Welcoming every experience that's present. And if helpful, interweave your inner resource of being and well-being throughout your body. Feeling secure and at ease. Sense all that you are now aware of. Everything a movement within awareness. Feel back into awareness. Spacious, unchanging awareness in which all of the changing sensations are arising and unfolding. Changing sensation revealing unchanging awareness. Setting aside the thinking mind, welcome the felt sense of being and well-being. Notice how being is arising in the unchanging spacious field of awareness. Now let go and dissolve into being awareness. Notice how awareness contains everything, pervades everywhere. As awareness, inquire, where is my center? Where is my periphery? Rather than thinking your way, feeling it. Awareness in which all perceptions are unfolding and passing away without form, without center, without periphery, everywhere and nowhere, yet an undeniable presence. Everything to be just as it is, without trying to understand or change anything. Simply being just as you are. Allowing everything to be just as it is. Being spacious, unchanging awareness. Allowing experiences to come and to go. Notice an emotion that's present in your body. Or perhaps something you've been dealing with in your life, a situation that's caused you negativity or stress. Can be a belief about yourself that you've allowed yourself to think is true. Story that you've been told about yourself. And notice how that feels in the physical body. If you need to, you can use your inner resource. And now, let it be helpful to think of the opposite. What is the opposite of that belief? The opposite of those negative feelings, the stories, the fears. What's the opposite truth? And notice how that feels in the body. Where do you feel it? Where's the change? Where's the lightness, the warmth? And as you're ready, alternate several times, going back and forth, allowing one to be true and then the other. Noticing how each acts upon the body, the mind. And now hold both of these opposites, these emotions, of these beliefs, whatever it is that you're dealing with, working with in your life. Hold both of them as true at the same time, allowing there to be two alternate realities. But can you hold on to the feeling of the one that makes you feel good? The one where everything is all right, where you aren't those negative things you believe about yourself or have been made to believe about yourself. Can you hold on to that spacious awareness that you are the blue sky, everything else is the weather? And begin to let those stories all fall away, shedding away from you. Leaves falling from a tree. And come back to the joy of your inner resource. Everything just as it is, without trying to change, understand, or fix anything. Simply being just as you are. Welcoming everything just as it is, as a teacher, as a messenger, perhaps as a friend, being spacious and unchanging, allowing experiences to come and go. Take a moment and reflect back upon the journey that you've just taken. Sensing some of the qualities that are or have been present, feelings, emotions, thoughts, sensations, and awareness. Awareness in which everything is arising, unfolding, and passing away. And be aware of your heart's deepest longing once again, allowing it to announce itself. Experiencing it as your present reality again, letting it be true. Noting an intention that supports living this heartfelt desire, this heartfelt longing, this lifelong mission. Feeling an intention arise that supports that, so that you can make everyday life work towards that goal. Imagine going about your day while feeling your inner resource as an ally, unchanging being and well-being, and yourself as unchanging awareness, in which all of the changing activities of your life are unfolding. Emotions, thoughts, sensations, your personality, and this indescribable sense of being unchanging awareness, sensing the paradox of being both spacious and vast awareness, without border or boundary, all while being this personality that has location, center and periphery, your body, your mind and your personality, free to be who they are, as they are, perfect as they are, sensing and affirming how in each moment you know the exact perfect perfect response to any situation that you could encounter. You just need to trust your deepest knowing, the inner sense. Begin transitioning now. Take your time transitioning towards a waking life, reintegrating. When it feels right, opening and closing your eyes several times gently while feeling your inner resource still present with you. You are an unchanging being. Returning to your eyes open state of waking consciousness. Alert, awake, and grateful. Grateful for taking this time for yourself and for your practice. Coming fully back to your eyes open, wide awake, an alert state of being. Allow yourself to move, the body to stretch. That was about a 45-minute guided meditation. Again, if you fell asleep, that's okay. That's just what your body needed. If you were alert the whole time, that's what your mind needed. What we did is we went through a lot of stuff. You know, we went through lots of layers. We went through our senses, our breath, our bodies, our beliefs, our joy, our goals, the intentions that we use every day to help us work towards our goals. And then we kind of worked our way backwards and came right back to where we are, to being awake and alert, hopefully with that sense of your inner resource still hanging on, that positive, that happiness.